Hi, I'm Dr. Sam Lamb, facial plastic surgeon in Plano, Texas. Sorry for the weird rings around my mouth. I'm just wearing my COVID mask, which I wear all day long. Today's subject is going to be talking about the radiofrequency microneedle we offer. A lot of patients inquire, what are the benefits, what is the downtime, what's the experience, you know, why do this? First of all, we have to talk about the technology. So microneedle, there's a lot of people talk about microneedle. They say, oh, it didn't work for me, it's useless. And I would say, honestly, just conventional microneedle is not that effective. And conventional microneedle is just needles going through the skin. You can do that with a skin pen or various things like that. RF microneedle is a totally different mechanism. So it is not the microneedle that's doing the work. The microneedle is delivering the radio frequency, the RF, the energy. So the way that our unit works is that there's a vacuum seal that seals down onto the skin. The needles then go through the skin, and we can vary the depth of the needles depending on how deep we want to treat, from 2 to up to 3.5 millimeters. And we usually treat a deeper 3.5 millimeters. So it goes through the skin, and the outer epidermis is protected from the heat through little tiny insulation devices, so that only the dermis is heated up. So the radio frequency is now tightening up that dermis. The dermis is that middle layer of skin. That dermis is what is where our collagen is found. It's where the area starts to fragment as we get older. So we really want to stimulate that level. Why do that? Acne scars? Where does acne scars sit? Acne scars sit at the dermal level, not subcutaneous level. So you can stimulate the fat, but it's not going to do anything. You want to stimulate the dermis. And the dermis starts to get thicker and thicker and gets better. Now, I usually use silicone micro injections for deeper to moderate scars, but for sort of more superficial acne scars where my silicone won't work as well, the RF microneedle works incredibly well. My staff does it, I don't do it. But the reason is that it's so brain dead easy, because a machine, when a vacuum seals down, it shows exactly where the last pass was, and you can't lift it off. You cannot engage needles. The needles are automatically engaged. The heating is automatically heated, and we can change the energy settings for that. Also for texture, tone, pores, also for patients down the lower face where that crepey neck skin that doesn't look good is really easy to treat with that. It does take at least 2 rounds, usually every 3 to 6 weeks, 4 to 6 weeks of treatment. The issue with this is that I can also do it with mesobotox or microbotox treatments, but that is much more expensive. Mesobotox, microbotox works better on wrinkles and texture than the microneedle, but I think together they work even better. So meso or microbotox, just quickly for you, is very dilute Botox placed into the dermis across a wide area to rebuild the collagen. Microneedle also does the same thing, but takes a little longer and more sessions to get to the results. I won't go into deep detailed description of meso or microbotox. You can look at that video that I have about that subject. So microneedle is typically very minimal downtime, but sometimes you can see little dots. If you are not wearing makeup to cover it, especially the neck and chest, it may take a little bit longer. We numb the area beforehand, usually 30 minutes to an hour, depending on the area. And after you're numb, we do the microneedle. For some of the deeper treatments like acne scars, there can be a little bit more discomfort. We can add, in addition to that, some nitrous gas, things like that, if need be, if you feel more discomfort. But the nice thing with it, in general, it's safe in all skin types, even to Fitzpatrick 6s, which means dark Central African skin, there's no issue. And also, in general, it's safe also in the sun, if you're getting some sun. So for example, if I'm doing micro laser peels, other photofacial treatments, those are things that I would not encourage you to be in the sun. But in general, microneedle is safe. Of course, there's a theoretical risk if you're getting a ton of sun after microneedle that you could have some temporary pigmentation issues. But in general, because you're treating the dermis, you're bypassing the epidermis, that you're really not having so much of a sun risk afterwards. And so that really, just to drive down and have you understand this in a concrete way, the microneedle is treating the dermis, the middle layer, the collagen, not the surface skin color. It's not treating this very surface damage, although there's some benefit to that. It is really the deeper quality of skin. So hopefully that is a short summary that has you understand better of how RF microneedle works in our hands.